Beauties, welcome back to my channel. So I am back with another video, and this time it's with the highly requested to do a video about all about my hair, how I take care of it, how I've grown it, and all about my hair. First things I want to talk about are the products I use for my hair, what I use to take care of it, like as shampoo, conditioner, you know, heat protectants and all that stuff. So the first thing I want to talk about is my shampoo. I use two shampoos. One of them is strictly mainly just for the focus of the growth of my hair. I don't have it with me right now, but I will insert right now a picture of it or a little video of it in the store so you guys can know which one I'm talking about. It's the Tailmane shampoo. I use the shampoo and the conditioner, and this has always 100% worked for me to grow out my hair. It works so amazing. It leaves my hair so soft with the conditioner. You have to use both of them in order for it to work, because I've only bought in the shampoo once and did not use the conditioner, and for some reason it was not just working out for me. Those are, they're not really that expensive. You can find them anywhere like CVS, Target, Walgreens, Walmart. I know they sell their shampoo like everywhere. I've seen it everywhere. And I also know that they have it at Ulta, if I'm not wrong. And basically, the way it works is if you dye your hair, it's not going to work for you. Because from the experience I've seen in my mom and other people that I know, that personally I know that they dye their hair every month or so, it does not work for them. It only works on natural hair. So if you have the ombre effect, it's still going to work for you, because you know, you're not doing anything to the top of your roots, so that's going to be a good point for you. So yeah, just keep in mind that if you want to grow your hair, you need to let the roots come out and let it be your original hair color, because if you're dyeing it, for some reason it's not going to work. It only works on natural hair color, and this is my natural hair color. Once I get to the length I want, I go ahead and use my Tresemme Split Remedy shampoo, and this really just focuses on my split ends and all that stuff, so it could, you know, really be healthy and shiny. And I don't really use a lot of other shampoos. I mean, I've always used and gone out and tried new ones and everything, but they're just like for the scent and for the smoothness, but not really to take care of my hair. So this Tresemme shampoo and conditioner, because I also have the conditioner, which let me show you. So here's the conditioner. I love this conditioner, and the great thing about Tresemme, the shampoo, it doesn't really have a strong odor. I know some girls go crazy about like the odor and everything, but I'm not that kind of girl, because I don't like putting my perfume and then at the same time my hair is smelling some other different smell. So I like that this does not have like such a strong smell. The way I use this is I wash my hair like every 2 days. I try to go at least 3 days without washing it. But every time I do wash it, I only grab a small little portion of this shampoo in my hand, and I only focus this on the top of my hair, like right at the roots. I don't really like to concentrate it at the ends, like where my split ends are, because that does make my hair more dry. So I mainly focus this on the roots of my hair and massaging upwards. So that way I get more volume and it doesn't weigh my hair down. So this technique for me works so much, because this is how I get my volume. For the days I don't want any volume and I'm gonna straighten my hair like today right now that you guys are seeing me, I don't really do that. I just basically just, you know, massage my head through the top, but not really giving it that little oomph effect, you know, you know what I mean? So yeah, that's basically what I do. And then I wash it off. And once I grab my conditioner, I grab another little small portion, because I'm only going to use it at the bottom. So I only focus this right about where my neck is, all the way down to my split ends. And that's where I concentrate my conditioner. I don't really focus this at all on the roots of my hair, because conditioner does weigh your hair down, and it also makes your hair fall out more, which that was a huge problem for me, and that was a huge mistake of my part of using so much conditioner and putting it to the roots of my hair, where I was always, you know, having so much hair fall out. And not only was it just the conditioner, it was the way I was like doing it that was making it, you know, break out more and, you know, having more fallout. This is not the correct form to do it. Like, it just massaging is the right way, because if you're doing this, you're basically just ruining your hair and making it more damaged, you know? So that is something I try to completely stay out of, like going all crazy with my hair. Even if I'm in a hurry, I'd rather not wash my hair. I'd rather wait until I have the time to wash it, because taking care of my hair is something really big for me. And once I'm done with that, I just rinse it off. I don't do anything else to my hair. I just shampoo and condition it. That is it. I don't like to put any treatment oils or any of like other treatments, you know, because my hair really doesn't really need any of that, because I don't dye it. I don't really put so much heat into it. And for the days I do put a lot of heat into my hair and I'm gonna strain it or something, or curl it or make it wavy or something with some tools, then I use my Tresemme Thermal Creations heat protectant. It's up to 450 degrees Fahrenheit of heat protection, and this makes the whole difference. Even if you think this is not going to make a difference, or if you've been using it and you don't think it's making a difference, it really is. Because trust me, they don't make this stuff just because. There's a purpose for it, and it really does work to protect your hair. If you could invest at least $10 in a heat protectant, I highly, highly recommend that, because it will make a huge difference in your hair. It's going to make it more healthier. And I know sometimes we girls tend to forget, you know, that extra step, but try to make an effort for it, because it really does make the difference in your hair. That is why my hair doesn't get super damaged all the time, because I'm always putting a thermal heat protectant. So now for the tools I use, I am very like not picky about the tools I use. I just basically go for whatever, and I keep that for like the next 10 years. I'm not even kidding. The thing I do use to blow dry my hair is this Infinity by Conair. It's just basically this normal, your basic blow dryer. It has like the cool shot right here where if you turn it on and you press this, cool air will come out, not really super hot. And then it has the temperatures and how hard you want this to be blowing out. It has from warm, medium, and hot. And to turn it on, it has the low speed, medium speed, and high speed. So I mainly always keep it all the way to the highest, because I do have a lot of hair. And the speed, I keep it in full blast because I don't have a lot of time in the mornings. I don't know about you guys, but I don't. And I like to go through my hair really quick and dry it fast. So that is why I'm saying that the heat protectant makes a huge difference, because if I wouldn't be using that, I would be doing so much damage to my hair, because I would be using this and then on top of that, I would be straining it with another heater, or either, you know, doing my waves, and that would be a lot of damage to my hair. So it's just basically your normal blow dryer with some settings. You could make it to your own personal needs for your hair, and yeah, I just totally love it. The other tool I'm going to talk about is the one I do to straighten my hair. So this is her. This is the Sidhu Revolution, and I got this about like, I would say 5 years ago, and it's still going strong. This hasn't died on me. It works like since the first day I got it. Works exactly the same. It has the turn on and off button. So right now if I turn it on and it turns red, that means it's like heating. I don't know if you guys could tell, maybe not, but it turns red, and once it starts flashing like blue and red, that means it's ready to use. And on the side it has like your heat, how you want your heat. Like the lowest it'll go is 170 and the highest it will go is 450. I always keep it maximum because, again, I like to go through my hair really fast and just get it over with and be out the door as soon as I can. The prices, I will include them down below because I don't remember how much these were. The wand I use to do my waves that you guys are always seeing me with is this one. This is from ESO Professional. And I got this on Shoe Dazzle. They were like, there was this time where Shoe Dazzle was like selling extra stuff other than shoes and handbags and jewelries. And this was one of them, and I really wanted a wand. I had never used one. It was like this, I got this like, I don't know, right when Shoe Dazzle started. And I got it, and at first I was neglecting it because I didn't really see any tutorials of how to use this, and I would try it and I was like, no, I don't like it. And I kept neglecting it, and then until, you know, not too long ago, probably like 2 years ago, I started using it and I haven't stopped using it. This is my favorite wand. I believe this is like the 1-inch barrel, and this is like perfect for my hair. And I'm so happy with it. It's still going strong. It hasn't died on me and it works amazing. It doesn't have anything like to put it at to your heat preference, because all you do is just turn it on. It goes super hot. I don't know how hot, but it goes really, really hot, because I burned my shoulder once and oh my god, it hurt like a bitch. So it really burns and it just gets super, super hot. And then, you know, you just turn it off by turning it off right here, and that's it. But yeah, I really recommend this one. It's really good. The only bad thing, like I said, is that you can't put the heat preference of your own. But I'm okay with it. I just try to be more extra careful because I am always burning myself with it. Even if it's just like my fingers, but I always have to get burned every time I use it. That's why I use a glove now. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is something super important. And I just recently started using this. And this is my hair, my brush that I use to brush my hair. And it's by Goody or something like that. It looks like this. And it's just like a weird looking brush. But seriously, when I saw this at Walmart, I read that it's a... What did it say? I'll leave the description right now. But basically, all I read was that it was extra careful with your hair. You could also brush it while it was wet, which is something I tend to wait for my hair to dry a little bit more so I won't damage it. But this one, you could brush your hair while it's wet, and it's so perfect. It's so good. So if you guys could invest in a brush where it's not gonna be like your normal brush, where if you're in a hurry and you're always like brushing out your hair and you're getting all these knots and you're just like damaging your hair, try to invest in one of these combs. They're not even that expensive. I got mine for like $5. I'm not even kidding. It was so cheap, but it's so good at what it does. It has made a huge difference in my hair, and I just am so happy with it. That was it for my hair care. Everything I use for my hair, it's pretty simple. I don't really do much to my hair, and you mean, give this a thumbs up if you found anything helpful, or if you guys also want to try out some of these products and you're loving that, let me know. That would make me happy to know that it's actually also working for other girls. And yeah, if you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe so you guys can see my future videos. And until next time, you guys, stay all blessed, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!